Welcome back to Let's Play The World Ends With You. In last episode, we started the post-game and I went to the next day already. Yeah, we can now access the chapters, go to each day, finish the missions to get stars and secret reports, and I have to read this one as well. The UG exists as a separate plane where the composer can judge the worth of man. Within it are Reapers and human players. It is infeasible for the composer to judge all of humanity by himself, so a filtering system utilizing the Reapers was created. The Reapers game. Reapers act as a test, weeding out unfit players. Upon becoming a Reaper, one's physical body changes, gaining incredibly strength and extended lifespan. As Reaper and player alike progress through the game, engaging in imagination-driven combat, the soul is refined. Soul is an abstract matter revealed through our research into life and death, and a component in the makeup of the atmosphere. Humans will thought all phenomena. Okay. As Reapers execute the game, they undergo a process of evolution from grunts to officers to the composer. However, Reapers that follow that ideal route are rare, and most are erased by players. Reaper or player, those erased within the game disperse the mind and spirit housed within their flesh in form of soul. Thus, they are erased only from visible existence. Their soul persists in the UG, until gathered and tied together according to a new code. This new code is essentially imagination. Given sufficient imagination, any form is possible, be it a pin or a Reaper. So you can make out of a soul, you can make a Reaper as well. Or a pin, which was the case for Rhyme, I guess. Variations in this code cause the soul to manifest in different forms. In other words, humans, Reapers and Noise are all entities formed of soul. The only difference is their code. And what are Noise? Entities without conscious will, only the drive to multiply. Thus, they constantly thirst for soul, attacking players and possessing humans in the real ground. Soul consumed by Noise is destroyed, even if the Noise is erased. Thus, possessed humans often exhibit a rush of euphoria immediately after the Noise is removed. Though untested, the same would likely hold where a player or Reaper possessed. Okay. So, our next mission on day 2. Is to get the white. The Mr. Ducky. White, which is probably Reaper Creeper, and eliminate the boss symbol. Okay, then let's see if we can find it. There's a guy to talk to already. Where is this merchandise coming from? Whatever, I just want to play Reaper Creeper. So, it's supposed to go to white. And it's white. Okay, Reaper Creeper. No boss noise around here. I guess I have to go where the Reaper stands. And AMX, okay. But no boss here. Let's see to AMX now. Nothing here. There is a other noise. Let's beat this one for now.
You're good as gone.
Yeah. I can't. I got this.
Yeah. All right. Easy enough. Yeah, I could try out a new pin. Ah, let's see.
Losing's not an option.
Dun, 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 dun. Ah, but no boss noise here around either. Okay, then let's go to this guy and ask him. On past this wall. Then wipe out two of the these areas, noise symbol, largest, alright. But I need 1 second. Okay, sorry for the interruption. So, yeah, the two of the largest noise, yeah, alright. Let's do it then. one and... Ah, come on. Didn't want to get to me. Whatever. Let's try out the new pin. Ooh, cool. Strikes all enemies through it. That's interesting. Okay. And we're getting some pins. And something was suggested. Which means more. Bravery by 6. Bravery by 2 and 5 modes, so 3 times would be 15. Have 6 bytes. 5 bytes. I gotta say, the bravery seems to be more efficient. But I'm actually going to... Ah, whatever. Let's give her some ice cream for now. There, you. Come here. I got some talk with you. Or let's say I want to smash you. This electric zap is really good. The downside is you can't really move while you do this. So you can't just break it up while it's activated. But other than that, it's really a cool pin. Okay, let's add another one. What do you do? Drag across empty space to create a path of flame. Why not? So yeah, should be able to go through now. Objective met. And money. Like this, I could just start over the chapter and get money. Make the 10,000 times 10. Is this? Oh, this guy here, right here, looked like Mina Mimoto for a second.
Open up your senses.
Let's see. Is here somewhere a boss noise? I'm not seeing it. Okay, I wanted to say, are they here now all the time? That would be a bit weird. And I couldn't get anything from here. Muchas gracias. So, let's see what this Reaper wants. Okay, we already have it. Let's go to Molko. Maybe here is something. Boss noise? Question mark? Are you here? Somewhere? There it is. Alright. Which means increasing our level, checking our pins, realizing I don't really have good ones on right now, thus changing this and this one. The rest should be fine. Okay, let's do it. Wait. I gotta do it on hard. Alright. Let's see if we can beat it. We could even do chain battles with other monsters. But better not. Your good is gone. Come on. Okay. Not here yet. I'm just closing this window so it won't get in the way. Okay. So far, so good. There it is. Ah, god damn it, I wasn't able to attack at this point. It's all you. I got this. Got it. The Path of Flame isn't really helping here. Ah, god damn it. Yeah, the Path of Flame was a bad choice here. Alright, that was a lot of damage. We hit him with like 3 attacks and it was over. Great. Okay, that wasn't really difficult. We are, after all, a lot stronger than we were back then. So I guess it's quite normal. Yeah, now we need just a white. Let's see. Throwing you out. Getting you back in. Taking you in as well. And I guess just throwing another E into this. Because I like the slash attack. It's pretty much a standard for me to always have it in. It makes things a lot easier, I guess. So let's see. Healing, why not? One of those, we already have these. So let's buy just some stuff which we don't have yet. Like this, and this, and this, and this. Once I pretty much got the stuff already which I want to have, I just throw out money like crazy. Even though it's not the best choice to do so, but whatever. I mean, I could get a lot of better equipment right now. Okay, we gotta beat some noise here. So let's see what we can get. Chain 2, I hope this is enough.
You're good as gone.
We'll see. Alright.
Yeah, that was great. Your good is gone.
Wow, that was a lot of pins. 15 yen, 1 yen pin, 9 10 yen, and 3 1000, cool. Alright, I think I digested something and didn't put in another. So let's do that now, and increase the attack for Neku for now. Increasing Neku's attack till he can't even do anything anymore and then kill people, or noise. I want to do a heck ton of damage. That's pretty much always what I do in games. Like in my German Grandia let's play right now. Where Justin is just like killing everything. Okay. This attack is really good. And then again, many pins. Okay, and we did what we had to. These two attracting the noise. Wonderful. I'm giving you another swirl.
So yummy.
What do you actually need right now? 190, 210, and 190. So after this one you can actually use the Mrs. Claus outfit. Great. So let's go to these two. I guess we have to fight the noise first. That are around them. Let's do it.
Your good is gone.
Should be fairly easy. What? Did I just see it right? I can use the spin twice? That would be cool. Zapping in two directions.
Your good is gone.
Okay, let's see.
That was nothing.
No, only once. What was that just now? Maybe a little glitch.
Watch yourself. I can't.
Will be the first I found in this game.
I got this.
There, twice. How the hell?
That was nothing.
I guess you can use it with each hand once.
That's how it's done.
Maybe I should try like one on the right and one on the left. Maybe then it works. And it takes care of the noise, but nope. So let's figure out what we have to do. We have to touch and imprint the Reaper Creeper. Sounds like fun. And now move to the white. Right. And again to white. And another one. Everything to white. To get Mr. Ducky or whatever. There's the box with Mr. Ducky. Set his herbal scent duck into the tub and it starts singing and swimming around. Bath time was never this much fun. Great. So yeah, we got now Mr. Ducky. Bravery 100. So Neko can almost use it. Defense plus 30. Which is really good, I'd say. Here. Oh, you already have, I guess, this one. Yeah. I guess Shiki has now better defense than ever before. Anyway, with this we should have the secret report. Yes. The real ground and underground are planes of existence. Other planes exist as well. The one inhabited solely by noise, for example, or our customary plane. Okay. The planes are stacked in parallel, though each exists at a different frequency vibe, in tune with its inhabitants. Observing a lower plane from a higher plane is simple. Actual transplanar contact, with, while possible, is highly complex. The vibes of adjacent planes are closer, making passage between them comparatively easier. God, oh God. More distant planes show greater difference in vibe frequencies, and thus communion becomes more difficult. The UG exists just above the RG, allowing those in the UG to observe the RG, but not vice versa. Noise exists on a special plane that straddles both the RG and UG, enabling the interference in affairs of both. When players come into contact with noise, they are drawn into the noise plane. In other words, players are forcibly tuned into the noise plane. Conversely, there exists an even higher plane than the RG and UG. That is where I am from, the plane of the angels. As in the RG and UG, angels have created a web of social schema to guide their activities. The role of producer is just one cog in the angel machine. Angel vibes are extremely high frequency, not even the composer can catch them all. In actuality, he can pick up only that of the producer. As you can see, interplanar contact is beset by difficulty, but certain modes do exist for its realization. One is the modulator decal, within its area of effect. Players from the UG can manifest visibly in the RG and communicate with others there. Reapers and composers can downtune their vibes at will. Near these decals, however, even their vibes will be forcibly adjusted to the lower frequency. Another mode, imprinting, requires no physical manifestation in RG. Imprintees experience the conferred thoughts as bursts of inspiration. The reliability of these communiques thus depends upon the person receiving it. For example, successful communication with preoccupied people is unlikely. Furthermore, recipient interpretation of said inspiration colors is the message, making imprinting unreliable at best. Reaper Creeper was created as a mode of popular communication between the planes. Modulating paralog logos printed on paper allow for limited UG interaction with real ground objects. As those in the RG are unaware of players, they perceive the illusion a coin moving by itself. Oh god, really high stuff. Pretty much explaining how people interact with each other from different planes. Get the solid slammer, totally gnarly. Okay. Track down and eliminate all of this chapter's pick noise symbol, which we already did. This is pretty much why I did this anyway. Should you report for day 5? We have that, and for day 3 we have this as well. So let's start off with this at least, so that we don't have to view the opening scene in the next episode again. All right. So the new mission. Well, Shiki is pretty much down here, and we have this with Makoto, and we have to get the Q floor in 3 hours. So let's see. What are we supposed to do here? I don't really remember. Oh yeah, he has a noise, alright. Let's fight the noise then for now. And after that I will end the part.
Watch yourself.
Okay. Ah yeah, I forgot. I want to try it out, but let's see. Sometimes it works, but not always. Obtained rare metal. Yeah. So, let's see what he's going to do. Totally gnarly. And I guess we have to talk to everyone saying totally gnarly for now. But anyway, as I said, we will do this in next episode. Until then, see ya!